Hello and welcome in this tutorial where I want to show you how to record your PowerPoint with Camtasia. When you install Camtasia, you install the program and the recorder. It automatically also adds this add-in into PowerPoint, but it doesn't matter if you use this add-in or you manually open up the recorder and start recording, because when you use this, it does exactly the same, only it opens when you start your presentation. I would like to use the recorder manually because this will give me the same result, only I will have the everything which I recorded prior to hitting start presentation. So you have your recorder, you have a big red button here, you simply click record, then you go to your PowerPoint, you can hit F5 or you can go here on the bottom side to slideshow. Oh, and my first mistake is not making this minimized. So I would go back. I would waste important seconds. I would minimize this recorder and now I would start my presentation. Everything on my screen right now is recording, so I would explain our design better presentation to you. I would go forward with my presentation and also the camera is recording in case you have a camera, and you can of course select if you want a camera or if you do not want a camera. And I also selected to record my entire screen because my screen is bigger than a full HD normal video. So I have the presentation, it's running. I'm using my arrow keys to navigate through the presentation. I'm explaining you all the steps and I would be finished. I would thank you for the presentation. I would thank you for watching, which I'll do later. And you can go back to your recording and you hit stop. Hitting stop opens a new window and you can save your recording. Here on the right side, you can click save and you select a place where you want to save your recording. Once the recording is saved, Camtasia will open up automatically and the Camtasia file will automatically import here into the media bin. Let me do this right now. I'll import the 2 minutes and 20 seconds I have. I'll click stop. Okay, I'm continuing the work right now. As you can see, I have a new recording. The audio level is like that. My camera is also recording. Let's maybe minimize this. And as you can see, the recording has been imported. What I would do, I would just go to the place where the presentation started. It was somewhere around here. Okay. It recorded because PowerPoint scales at full HD and my screen is bigger. This is why the screen here is smaller. So what to do now? At first, I would take this and press Ctrl X to delete everything prior to the presentation. Then I would go at the end. Here was the end of the presentation. I would take all that, Ctrl X again. If you don't want to use shortcuts, you can also click here. Where is it? I'm only using the shortcut, so not paste, of course, cut. Boom, cut. So this is my presentation. What I would do now, I have two sources. I have my camera source and my video source. The video source should be bigger to be extended to the entire screen. Okay, perfectly. I have it now on the entire screen. And the camera, if you want the camera, I would make it bigger. I would press my left alt key to crop it and into visual effects. This is only in my case because I have a green screen behind me. I would drag and drop, remove the color. I would make the tolerance to around 70%. This usually gets the job done. I would make this smaller. I would put myself here. And boom, we have the ready presentation. Maybe I'm in the way. We have the presentation. Everything is well recorded and ready basically for publishing. In order to publish, you need to render out the video. Now you may ask, what size is the video? I know that the video was recorded in a high quality, so I will render it out as a full HD file. I'm usually pressing Ctrl P to produce the video, Ctrl P. But if you don't know where it is, you can simply go to share and custom production. I prefer to have a custom production setup, but you can add a preset or just simply go a new custom production. MP4 would be my preferred file format. I'm going forward. Always deselect this because this produces some kind of video controller for this Camtasia type of video, but you do not want that. You want a normal MP4. The size will of course remain full HD, but if you want to go HD, I'd go 1280 by 720. Video settings. Now the frame rate, 30 FPS, the 60 was just a test. 60, the quality, around 70%. I publish all my videos at around 70% quality. This gives me rather high quality rendering than a lower quality. The files are a bit bigger, but it's not considerable. I think we should go for quality. So select the quality as you would like. Click next, next, finish. This would be the ready video press. It takes a few seconds to render, but I would have my rendered ready video ready to publish. And this is it. How you record videos, how you record videos with Camtasia and use, for example, your presentation as the source. I'm stopping now the recording. Thank you very much for listening, and I hope you can very soon record your own presentations and of course videos as well. See you in the next tutorials.